Take a look at the newest threat to our national security, H5N1, or the bird flu virus. Now, it's been smoldering in Asia for years, killing millions of birds and causing 62 human deaths. In humans, the flu is still confined to Asia, but infected birds are cropping up all over Europe, possibly even Canada, where they're investigating a recent spate of bird deaths.
If the virus were to develop the capacity for sustained human-to-human transmission, it could spread quickly across the globe. Our country has been given fair warning of this danger to our homeland and time to prepare.
And time is crucial, because if a global bird flu epidemic were to happen, and no one's saying it is for sure, it could kill tens of millions of people. Faced with that possible disaster, the Bush administration is asking for $7.1 billion to fight a health crisis that right now doesn't even exist here. Bird flu in humans was first detected in 1997 in Hong Kong. That year, six people perished. As the cases mounted over the years, so did the frightening facts. Of every two people that gets bird flu, one dies. The best protection we have against that is a vaccine, but we won't have that in the foreseeable future.
Not in clinics, not in hospitals, not even in emergency rooms like this one at Emory, where I work. See, the issue is that once the vaccine is created, a new problem might arise. The virus might change, and the new vaccine might not work as well. Maybe not at all. So the president wants to spend some of that money on vaccine technology to try and speed up the whole process.
Another part of the plan will be obtaining more medicines like Tamiflu, which could stem the symptoms of bird flu, but not stop them. The problem now is there aren't enough doses. Which brings us to the most important part of the Bush plan. Surveillance, specifically in Asia. That is, stopping the disease at the source. And that's a lesson we learned with grim consequences in 2003, when SARS broke out in Asia. Surveillance against that disease was inadequate, and it spread into several countries, infecting more than 8,000 people, killing nearly 800. But as I recently learned on a trip to the Far East, no amount of money can guarantee that surveillance on the ground will stop avian flu.
Here in Thailand, they pride themselves on having a strong surveillance system. But the Mekong River is just behind me, and on the other side of that, Laos, where they barely have a public health system whatsoever. And birds and the viruses they carry don't respect the border.
The Bush plan does look ahead to the possibility of bird flu crossing our own borders. The implications? Huge. Quarantines imposed by federal and state governments, having to deal with massive shortages of isolation beds and respiratory equipment.
Right now, we have the makings of a pretty good idea of where we want to go. We just don't know yet how we're going to get there or exactly how much it's going to ultimately cost us to get where we need to get.
But it is a start, even if it is dealing with a disaster that doesn't yet exist. Dr. Sanjay Gupta, CNN, reporting.